further over this way, just out of interest, is the within the magic circle, if you will, and then you would have the altar there, and then kind of foliage in a way emanating out of the top of the foliage. Just as a matter of interest, within the arrangement here, within the sword, there is the light aspect to it, if you look closely. Down here we have a portrait of the Earl of Jersey, Grand Master of the United Grand Lodge of New South Wales. Now, further up here, we have the exhibition building right there. And you can kind of see the vortex there between the two pillars, the interdimensional vortex, I would suggest, between the two pillars right there. And we can see reference here to Lord Carrington. Now, up here you have the two pillars, and you have that interdimensional vortex once again tied to the building. You can see the building right there, so you would have that central pillar within that building, and indeed I can show that configuration so many times it's not funny. Just notice they've got the growing cells, a part of growing up right here, with the Vegemite, very Australian product, very Masonic. So here we would have the steps going up, there's your general public right there, and then the steps going up, the pillars of Jachin and Boaz, and the portal way going right through, interdimensional portal for further light. Within the display here of King Solomon's Temple, and indeed there are various displays for this, but you have the front portal way through here, and then we'll just notice, among other things, that you have the emanation, or what I would suggest is the emanation out from the vessel there, from that vessel depicted there in the front. You have the ladder in here with seven steps on it, and you can see the levels, and within there you can see the kind of building the levels up, interdimensional levels. In the center there you have the palette there, where you're a bit like having plaster of Paris, building material on the, so building that pillar in a way, in the center there, I would suggest, within the temple here. You have the ritual room down here, again with the pillars and so forth in there. As I've said before, the displays keep changing here. So I come here and look at the various displays. And basically see what I can see. Now, within here we would have this is the jewel of the nine worthies, and the greater writing for this I'll just sort of scan through here for those who want to read fully. Now I just want to point out the configuration here of the pillars meeting at the top like they do. So, and then you have the participant in the top in the center also, and we have the star above, and if you look carefully you can kind of see there's a bit of a, you can see there is a kind of a pillar coming down the center also. So that central pillar represented there with the kind of magic circle configuration there also. Reference to the sun and moon, and then that inner sanctum with the one perhaps one participant right there, and the joining of the pillars. Further, there is a bit of a tapestry right here, and up the top, the sun and moon, and what would be a rainbow bridge, rainbow depiction right there, portal way going through. Now, interestingly, here among many other aspects, you have the three, one, two, three, in the central sort of configuration in the center. You have that here also. If we zoom in, you still have it. You've got the one, two, three, male, female energies with the depiction of the rising serpent on the caduceus in this case in the center. And you can see it, the consciousness kind of rising in a way out of the central figure right there. And the awareness, the participant becoming more aware of the space around him and entities, I would suggest. Here you have the participant with the cornucopia. Now, the position of the cornucopia is perhaps coming from either maybe the genital region, but the lower regions, and out of the cornucopia comes the foliage right there. Interestingly, you have that weird beardy thing there, which almost like an emanation from the mouth, strangely enough. 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 An emanation from the mouth.
Please notice the foliage on both these interdimensional creatures also. Foliage.
Find an emanation from the mouth, strangely enough. The energies of the coat, perhaps, but you know, magic square and other bits and pieces here. This one here, strangely enough, in a way, it just looks like an emanation from the mouth. Now, this may sound strange, but I can certainly show other configurations. And the weird part about these two participants here, or if we zoom in these two participants here, is that they are perhaps cherubim, shape-shifting cherubim. And if we look to further drawings and so forth, you can see the cherubim shape-shifting, and then in the three, the animals, it's either the animals or the people, etc. I only have to go over, scan over this way, and you can see the two figures there around there. So perhaps cherubim, elementals assisting the situation in light bodies, and perhaps changing the light body of human participants if they are there. So a lot of shape shifting going on. This is extremely difficult territory for someone who is not an insider. Now, this configuration here is, I just want to focus on for a moment. So you have two very small figures around the seat there, the seating position with the three steps, and just want to point out that the scale of the participants is very small. So they are very small compared with the seating arrangement. Now, we have a matter of scale, and not wherever you go, but in various places you will see the configuration of smaller creatures and larger creatures around the depicted. So this is another case where you can see that the seat is much larger. So just not an uncommon sight. Here, these jewels are laid out, the laying out of the cross right there. And within that, there was just numerous symbolism. Don't know if I can pick it up on the camera. On those jewels. At this point during the filming, a Freemason who had been, he came up to me and said he'd been listening in on what I'd been saying and that he was impressed with my knowledge. So I'm quite frank when I talk to some Freemasons. This guy was in his mid-30s. He came around to saying that he'd been up through and past the 18th degree, but I said because of a young family and because of the amount of study and so forth that masonry involves, he had kind of backed off a bit because he needed more time. He's not the first Mason I've talked to who has done this for various reasons. For example, another person in small business. So I talked to him about various things. He didn't sort of let on, but he just sort of, you know, kind of nodded his head in a way. And I was kind of saying crazy things, like I say. What might seem crazy to some people, like I say on my videos, but anyway. So we had a chat at this point. He'd been eavesdropping on what I'd been saying, and that's that. I'm now noticing that, we'll now go back to this exhibition that's going on, and here you can see a relationship with the human and the animal right here. And in this case, this is work by another artist. So there's the detail there. The single eye, third eye configuration there, I would suggest, but you've also got the crown chakra happening right there also with the Indian motif. And while we're on the roll, let's look at some further artworks around here. So we've got various artists, so I'm not sure who the specific artist is, but here we have the configuration of the human and the cat, and I would suggest that there is shape shifting going on with light bodies. Here's an interesting connection between male and female right here, but an interesting connection going on with cherubim masons in higher rituals and the light body of the participants. Just walking in here, and I was just sort of thinking to myself, how did I, because this is the third degree tracing board right here, and I was thinking, how did I miss this part here? Because the five, you know, you've got the third degree configuration there, basically. You haven't got the full tracing board, you've just got the coffin configuration there. But I was thinking, you know, how with these, what are magic circles right here, how did I miss it on here? Well, they aren't here, basically. We just have different symbolism. So I just thought I'd come back to have a look at this aspect. This is like a bit of an Australian variation here, but with the inclusion of this striking, most striking symbolism. Yet another aspect to it is that you have the garland type picture frame, the foliage around the edge of this picture right here. So very interesting, some of the detail there. You also have all of those orbs around there also. Quite a revealing depiction. Within the display here, you have this tracing board, and you can see the pillar of light on the book, the ladder, which is really a pillar of light, as you can see, with the kind of different levels going up, the heart chakra right there and all the rest of it on the tracing board. Interestingly, with the configuration here, going back to this, you have the two participants, and looking in closely at them, one of them's sort of holding something right there, but they're looking, one of them's sort of looking up also, and you can see Freemasons looking up over and over. That's part of the symbology. And you can definitely, hopefully you can pick out that that chair is much bigger than the participants, so they are around that, and you can see Leadbeater shows the exact same configuration basically. So it's right there. Now another thing here is that you have the beehive configuration here, and you have notice how you have the four legs, then you have the pillar, the edifice in the center there, and you would enter that building in a way, and around you can see beehive buildings, and then you've got the little accent at the top there, suggestive of a portal way going through, I would suggest, and this further configuration here as we kind of rise up through various configurations of consciousness, understanding, and also a visualization of things interdimensional. Whilst being here this time around, I had a Mason come up and talk with me one-on-one. He was overhearing what I was saying, he said, so he approached me and basically was just remarking that I had good knowledge. And then I started talking about a few different bits and pieces about magic circles and pillars of light. And yes, he has gone over the 18th degree, but he's now in the Blue Lodge and calls himself a third degree Mason in the Blue Lodge. But so that was quite interesting. So this, I had a dream at one stage, and it was a remarkable dream. I've only ever had it once, and I made a video about it. Now, in the museum here, now this was the area where there was a tent in my dream, and I was in the veil in the tent, and then within the tent, my body was kind of frozen, and I was about just about here. And I had a field around my body, and I knew, I could sense that I had that entire field around my body. And yeah, so basically this position right here in my dream was where that occurred, strangely enough. Here's that chair with the foliage, and here you have that double paw. So you have the foliage and then the lion's paw emanating out right there. I've got a bit of an exhibition thing happening here. Now that's an old exhibition with the Prime Ministers of Australia around here, and a remarkable amount of them openly were Freemasons. But anyway, we have some further depictions here, further bits and pieces. Now here we have these three pedestals, and these, if you look at the pedestals, among other things, look, they have the candle wax on them. But another aspect to these pedestals would be that you would have perhaps pillars emanating up from these also, and I would suggest that you can see symbology of this with that kind of pedestal and then the pillar above. We have the pillars of light down here and the greater exhibition area here, and here we have the further pillar of light right here, the lift. So, well, there are two lifts, Jachin and Boaz, of which one of them I'm going to enter. All right, so entering this pillar of light, and in this case we're going to go down to the first level. Exit this pillar of light right here. So that's one pillar of light. Sorry, you guys mind if I ground? Okay, so, and then further down here are the further pillars of light right here, and in this case they are the still not very well picked up on my camera, but purple pillars of light. Did you notice the light configuration, the circle and the point in the center on the floor as we exited the lift? Now within the Sydney Masonic Center on the ceiling, you would have that configuration, the circle with the point in the center of light. Indeed, it would be on two levels, but we won't get into that. So
This may remind us of what we saw with the tracing board earlier on. Now, the Freemason who approached me during my filming and made comment on my amount of knowledge, I happened to meet him as he was just coming down the stairs, which are nearby the sort of magic circle configuration with the lighting, and I pointed to the lighting and I said, look at the circle configuration there, the magic circle of lighting. And he kind of looked up, and he's very professional about the whole thing. He's not saying, oh yeah, that's a magic circle and all the rest of it. But he said, oh, well, I'll keep an eye out for the lighting, and, you know, didn't say, oh, you know, you're a bit of a loony or whatever. So very respectful, and indeed, as I am to people I meet also. So, what I noticed was that we met sort of just on the stairs there, and then he started, when we had finished our little conversation, he kind of went the other way. Maybe he remembered that he was going in the wrong direction, or maybe I bamboozled him a little bit with my comments, or surprised him, and he just sort of went the other way. So just found that a bit peculiar.
So I actually drove away from the Masonic Center, and I have now returned. Now, from that handle, you can see the emanation out. So imagine holding that in your hand. We have the vessel there, and you can see the emanation sort of out, if you will, with the flowers right there, orbs in a way, and you can see that in India in a way, from the hand. But if we go down here to the ceremonial batons and we look carefully. So with this one here, you have the black part in the center, and you have what is a kind of emanation out of the crown configuration. If we look at the other way, you have it also there. Now this is very like a garland in a way, and notice the kind of rings at the end of the black section also. There would be a further ring right there. And then you've got that crown, or that kind of lotus configuration. And you have the orb kind of squeezing out in a way of that portal right there, I would suggest. Now, in the depictions in Egypt, you can see the kind of garland configuration with that orb kind of coming out. And we have a look at that a few times over. Some people think it's a light bulb, which is ridiculous. And here we have a similar configuration here. And indeed, further in Sydney, on the footpath in Liverpool, you can see a similar configuration also. And in India, you can see similar configurations further. You can see similar configurations in Cambodia also, if you really look at things. So it's no wonder that we have imagery from Asia depicted in the museum here. Here's another view, and that would be that configuration there, that kind of wand, that light bulb. So I actually drove away in my car, and then made a return trip. Notice on this one you have the spiraling energies heading up this baton. Now it's in this room that, interesting places, but it's in this room that we have the reference to the wand and so forth within here.